Hello and welcome to this year's, the 2019 Bizarre Cricket 11. This is something we decided to do because, you know, you have serious good cricket experts to give you all the important news. You know, you'll have Harsha telling you stuff and you'll have Simon telling you stuff. But who's going to tell you the stuff from behind the scenes, the kind of funny stuff that nobody ever picks up on? I'm here, Joy Bhattacharjya, and I'm going to tell you all about what happens in this Bizarre 11. I'm going to start off with something which was after India beat New Zealand by 90 runs, and there was a rather sinister warning that came from the New Zealand police. So they turned around and said, "Police would like to issue a warning to members of the public about the exploits of a group touring the country at the moment. Witnesses see this group badly assault an innocent bunch of New Zealanders in both Napier and Maunganui in the last week. Extra care should be taken if you're carrying anything that looks like a bat and a ball." I thought it was really, really well played by New Zealand cricket. That was obviously the Indian cricket team that had such a good run, and they won that ODI series 4-1. So that was my first incident in the Bizarre 11. My second incident for the Bizarre 11 is a scorecard that you should hope to never see, especially if you happen to be the sports teacher of a school called the Children's Welfare School. They were playing in a Harris School match, and in Harris School matches in Mumbai, and it's very competitive, lots of big scores are made. Their opponents, Swami Vivekananda International School, made only 761 runs for 4 wickets. Yes, you heard that right, 761 runs. So if you're expecting a tough run chase, I only want to tell you that Children's Welfare School ended up with scoring 7 runs, none of them off the bat. I don't know what happened to their sports teacher, especially their cricket coach, but you can say they made history, but not particularly the right way. A batsman should be very happy when he scores a 6, except it doesn't always happen the way he wants it. Soumya Sarkar was batting and the ball went for a 6, but it went for a 6 after hitting the top of the stump. In effect, Jofra Archer was bowling so fast that it beat Soumya Sarkar, hit the stump and straight on went and hit the boundary ropes. And not only did Soumya Sarkar get out, I think the rest of the Bangladeshi batsmen were queuing, say, "I just have to go to the loo, why don't you go and bat there right now?" Well, that's how a bowler can score a 6 and do well as well. And in number 4, another incident from the World Cup, what can be heavier than bails? It turns out bails are the things that are heaviest, and I want to read a list of batsmen out there who will be praying for these heavy bails. Quinton de Kock against Adil Rashid, Karunaratne against Trent Bolt, Chris Gayle with Stark bowling to him, Saifuddin with Ben Stokes bowling to him, and of course, David Warner and Bumrah. All these gentlemen have benefited from heavy bails, and every bowler is looking at them and said, "Guys, did you need to have those colours in it? You just cost us wickets." Law 19.8. Have you ever heard of it? Law 19.8 of the cricket rules is what all of you probably have a very, very good idea of now, because that's a law that said if the ball goes and hits that bat on a throw, that overthrow is runs to the batsman. And that's something that every cricketer would be looking at, especially Ben Stokes and Mountain Guptill, and saying that is probably what made the difference in the World Cup final. And I think the best statement about all this was given by Ben Stokes. When he finished it, he said, "I will be apologizing for that the rest of your life." You will be, Ben. You will be, especially if you go back to your hometown. And after the World Cup, we had the Ashes series. And, you know, I think the most important thing of the Ashes series was the emergence of the Rajasthan Royals as a great test team. Yes, you heard me right. The Rajasthan Royals may not have done that well in this IPL, but they are probably the best test team going, because look at the man of the match winners for the Ashes series. The man of the match is there. Steve Smith got 2 of them. Ben Stokes got 2. Jofra Archer got 1. Who do they play for? They all play for the Rajasthan Royals. So next year, if you see another team enter the test arena, don't be surprised. And now for the most heartbreaking news, not just in the cricket world, but in the subcontinent. In September this year, the new coach of Pakistan, Misbah-ul-Haq, asked from his players what no coach should ask from his players. He asked them to give up biryani. Yes, you heard me right. He said, "These Pakistani players, we are not fit enough, we have to give up biryani." And I know there's a moment for sacrifice in the cricket field, but isn't it taking it too far? And if anyone would go back in the history books or, you know, look at YouTube and look at Inzamam ul Haq, that body was not made having salad. Think about it, Misbah, think about it. Well, we heard of many players being called magicians. Syed Ajmal used to be called a magician because he could bowl a dusra. But rarely have I seen actually a magician, you know, doing his stuff in the middle of a cricket field. And that's what Tabrez Samshi is doing out now. And he basically does a magic trick. He suddenly turns around and takes a piece of cloth. It turns out to be something else. It becomes a magic wand. And Tabrez, fantastic. It's a great celebration. But it will look even better if you took a few more wickets, Tabrez. That's what's going to get you into the IPL, not those celebrations. So, you know, we have heard of concussion replacements. Now we have replacements for almost anything in a cricket field. But I think Faf pulled out the best one. Sick of losing the toss, he decided to get a toss replacement. Yes, you heard that right. Themba Bavumba went out with him to call for the toss and he didn't get it right either. Bad luck, Faf. Better luck next time. Speaking of Faf, I mean, you know that, you know, South Africa's had a rough year this time, but I think he's been in top form otherwise. And there was a press conference right after a match, the Pal Rocks, and it's a great team and they were playing well together. In fact, I think they went and won the tournament this year. In one of the matches, just before the match, Faf was asked his team. And he said he's this, that. There's only one change and that's Vilhoen is not playing. And why is he not playing? The exact reason he gave us, one change. Hardest Vilhoen is not playing. He's lying in bed with my sister. I think it's really important that he said the next line, they got married yesterday. Either than that, it would have been a slightly dangerous statement on the cricket field. As it turned out, everyone loved what Faf said. And Pal showed that they're a team which is a really happy family by winning the tournament. Finally, I want to end with something that happened in India. You know, you've heard of, you know, tough bowling conditions. You've heard of venomous pitches. Well, the ultimate venomous pitch was made in Vijayawada this year. Andhra Pradesh was playing Vidarbha. And they walked in and they actually saw a snake in the middle of the pitch. And the snake was frightened away, but obviously there was something in it because Vidarbha got bowled out for 211. And that's what happens when you see a snake in the middle of pitch. They're not demons who are inside the pitch, they're demons outside it as well. And that's all in this year's edition of the Bizarre 11.